Captain Cook.
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
What do you be needing today, then? Run bit of business, that.
Guest, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Captain Cook?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever and cunning. Consider him an ally, but watch what you say around him.
Duly noted.
I've heard Louisbourg could be a linchpin in the war. If the Royal Navy can take that fort, it'll be clear sailing down the St. Lawrence.
Then on to Quebec and Montreal. The tide is turning.
General Wolfe will give that craven Montcalm a right thrashing. There she is. The HMS Pembroke. Captain James Cook's ship.
She's a beauty.
Man of war. Fully armed. We should bring the Morrigan alongside. Master Kenway will surely be waiting.
Welcome aboard, gentlemen.
Good to see you again, Captain.
Captain Shay Cormac? Captain James Cook.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Pleasure's mine, sir.
Captain Cook uncovered a rather distressing stratagem, which I fear confirms our own intelligence.
Indeed. As we speak, our Royal Navy fleet is on its way to Louisbourg. However, the French have drawn up a preemptive strike against it if they launch this attack.
Obviously, we cannot allow that to happen. Gentlemen, the Battle of Louisbourg could very well be the turning point which will finally bring this war to a close.
I don't know about you, but I've had enough of war.
Then may I suggest you take the wheel, Captain Cormac? I think you might enjoy piloting a vessel with real, firepower.
I believe I shall, Captain.
Lawrence and Whitmore lead the three divisions of the Royal Navy.
Who's their commander?
Major General Amherst himself, back from Hanover.
You take an interest in the war, Shay?
Wouldn't want to disappoint you, sir. Not let any through.
It is imperative we stop those ships, Captain. The outcome of the war and not a team.
Make good use of your own mortars. You'll prove crucial.
On your mark, Captain.
Fire!
Dear God, fire ships! Should they break through, they would devastate our fleet!
And we'd better not let that happen.
I recognize that vessel, sir! It's the Experto Credit!
Admiral.
How fortunate he is that we have other priorities.
Agreed. We have to get rid of those fire ships.
Fire! Incoming ship!
Fire!
Not friendly!
Ships, sir! And more fire ships!
This is hopeless. Perhaps it would be wiser to fall back.
Foreign wisdom don't always mix, Captain. This isn't over yet, lads. Man the cannons!
Yeah!
There's the Royal Navy!
We cleared the way just in time, Captain Cormac.
The tide of war is turning!
That was quite a crack, wasn't it?
It is too soon for celebrations. But Wale is still out there.
I'm sure we'll get another turn to dance with him, Master Kenway. Kenway. Determined to destroy Adewale.
Aren't you? He's a powerful man in his own right, and a symbol of hope for the assassins. Eliminating him would shake them to their core.
It would, I know. But it seems a shame. He's a good man, Guest.
So was the Elder Washington, and Smith. I rather enjoyed drinking with him. Wardrop, too, though the man could not hold his liquor. He and Weeks never got along.
If you're trying to test my conscience, Guest, you've succeeded.
We live in a time of war, Shane, but it's always wartime for us. I sound like my Uncle Jedediah. He was an old sourpuss. Let me tell you.
Of saying, there's the gun of surprise!
Hold it, sir! Do you enjoy your cargo?
Awaiting orders, sir!
Wait,
the lava! Grace!
Lord, you father, please, Lord!
Sails! Let's catch the wind!
I think we crashed a spur!
Don't turn!
bacon, bacon, meat and blood.
Although I am a yard,
please do not talk.
Thank you.
loose and trim to. Tops, gallants, royals, studs.
Full sails!
We are clear, Captain.
Of all you young sailormen, listen to me. I'll sing you a song of the fish in the sea, and it's
windy weather, boys, stormy weather, boys, when the wind blows, we're all together, boys, blow ye wind westerly, blow ye wind ho! Jolly sou'wester, boys, steady she goes.
Jumps the gale with a slippery tail, climbs up aloft and reefs the topsail,
and it's windy weather, boys, stormy weather, boys, when the wind blows.
That's the way. Yeah.